What's going on, guys? This is Kevin, aka 18 Wheeler Gamer here, bringing you guys another video here on the channel today. And we are joined by a very special guest, as you can see on the left screen over here. We are joined by the man, the myth, the legend himself, Rival Will. How you doing, Will?
Doing great, Kevin. Thank you for having me.
I'm very excited to be doing yet another reaction video today of the brand new movie trailer for the Marvel movie, The Eternals, which dropped yesterday. It dropped Monday by the time we get this video. I'm probably going to upload it on Wednesday. We're recording this on a Tuesday because I got back from vacation on Monday. And yeah. But I have not seen the trailer yet. Will has also not seen the trailer yet.
Nope.
I'm very excited to see what this trailer is all about and what's in it, what we're going to see. Both Will and I are very huge fans of the Marvel Cinematic Universe.
But I know nothing about the Eternals, yes. So I'm so excited to see what this is going to be.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. You know, as you guys know, I did the last reaction with Ash and Bri where we watched Shang-Chi trailer. And we're probably going to do this again with a bunch of the other movie trailers, such as Spider-Man. And a bunch of other ones. I actually really enjoy doing these reaction videos and all that. But that is a different topic for a different time. We're going to be reacting to the Eternals today. And I'm very excited to see what this trailer is all about.
Me too.
All right, are you ready to dive on in, my good sir?
I was born ready.
All right, let's do this. Where's the play button? I can't see. Okay, here we go. Oh, hi.
Nice music choice. Ooh.
Okay.
So we're a long time in the past.
What is that?
Speechphone.
Oh dear.
Listen.
Wait, what?
Are you nice people? Oh. Oh. Okay. Like Doctor Strange magic.
We have watched. Unguided.
Okay.
We have helped them progress.
That's a knife.
And seen them accomplish wonders.
November.
Okay. Throughout the years, we have never interfered. Until now.
Dear me.
Oh, you're welcome.
So now that Captain Rogers and Iron Man are both gone, who do you think's gonna lead the Avengers?
I could lead them.
No. Will you?
There's always that.
You can't do that. We don't know who you are yet.
there's always that little credit scene at the end where it kind of like the humor that they bring in. I always love that what they do.
Yeah, but no, no.
at least this kind of confirms where the timeline for the movie is, that it takes place after Endgame.
Well, kind of, because by the looks of it, it's going to like span a lot of time.
Well, because it's probably going to be. My theory is that based on the trailer, like around this part here, like all this part. Is probably like the backstory kind of showing like, hey, this is what happened.
You mean like in flashbacks?
Yeah. But because like the guy said here, or the kid was like, now that Iron Man and Rogers are gone.
I acknowledge that particular scene is taking place more in the modern, current, up-to-date time. But I don't know if that what we were looking at was going to take place in flashbacks, because they showed a lot from that. And then, like, as the society progressed, I feel like we're going to see, like, maybe an entire first third of the movie is getting us caught up to, you know, who the heck are these people?
Yeah.
I saw a speedster. I know I saw a speedster that just went.
I saw that too.
Right there.
I wonder, because, like, I wonder, this is going to sound a bit weird, but, like, I wonder if these are going to kind of be, like, a different dimension version of the Avengers.
Well, from what little I've heard.
Not really a different dimension, but, like, a different. Nah, I don't really know now. Because I can't say different universe, because that's the whole point.
Well, no, because what the Eternals are, if I'm understanding, is they're basically, like, the gods of. Yeah. Of this, so it's kind of, think kind of like Thor being like the Norse god of thunder. It's kind of like that, only these are the, I guess, the beings even over the Asgardians.
Yeah, that definitely makes a bit little sense.
But okay, so I got something I need to say.
Yeah.
In that whimsical, beautiful voiceover. For we watched, we did, we never interfered. Until now. Wait a minute. So, aliens invading New York, evil robot dropping city on planet, Titan wiping out half of the galaxy. They got this. What the heck is happening in this movie for them to say, okay, they need us now?
Yeah, no kidding.
We got to do something. Like, what? What are you doing?
That's so true, though. So true. I mean, it definitely makes you want. I mean, you gotta think too. It's just like kind of going back, because obviously Nick Fury called Captain Marvel at the end of Infinity War.
Yeah.
Why didn't he call her for a bunch of the other events? You know, it's
true.
It's also kind of one of those things. But you're absolutely right, because it's like, oh, this happened. This happened, and this happened. Now you want to step in? Like, it's probably, it's definitely, I mean, look, I'm assuming that this is a shot of the entire, I guess,
team. Okay, let's check out these guys while you got this. Okay, so obviously our two center people, they're going to be the main ones, it looks like. They're the, this is the leaders.
So it looks like, if I counted correctly, they're 2, 4, 6, 8, yeah, there's 10. Like main members.
Wow.
And we didn't really even get a shot. I think I saw a person in the green to the, like, next to the kid.
Yeah.
We saw her a bit more than a bunch of the other ones.
We did. We saw her basically, like, through the ages. There she was in, like, ancient times, and all of a sudden there she is in, like, a square in a city, maybe, like, in London or somewhere.
Yeah.
Did it, and I said this when we were watching it, when they were, like, creating things, did it not look like Doctor Strange magic?
Oh, no,
just
it
different
did.
Color.
It definitely did. It definitely makes you wonder. And, like, if anyone in the comments want to kind of explain some stuff without spoiling, like, stuff that happened or that could happen.
No spoilers.
Like, don't say that this person's gonna die. Like, if you can kind of know the concept, you know, of what this movie's gonna be about, you know, don't spoil that, because obviously I want to see the movie and not. But, like, if you kind of want to help us kind of understand what the Eternals are, who they are, and what they do.
I don't know if talking about what's happened in the comics would count as a spoiler, because This is Marvel Studios.
Yeah.
They're going to use what happened in comics as inspiration.
Right.
But then they're going to do their own things. Like, you look at the original comic for Civil War. Mm-hmm. And while basically, it's Captain America versus Iron Man. The actual motivation and what happens at the end of all of that could not be more different from the comic book from what happens in the movie.
It's funny that you use Civil War as the example, because I was actually watching that on a plane ride back on yesterday.
Well, it's a good one. It's a really good one.
It is a good one. But
okay.
I definitely think it just makes you one. It really is interesting to see who these guys are and what they're now. Going to do.
It makes me wonder if this is going to feel similar to the X-Men, because
that makes sense.
We saw one guy doing the magic thing. We saw one of them that looked like a speedster, like the Flash running on.
Yeah.
Okay. So all of these guys are powerful, but are each one of them going to have a different special skill? It makes them different.
Yeah. I'm sure.
Right?
That definitely would make sense. You know,
like if we have super strength over here, and we got super speed over there, and you can turn invisible, and you can shoot light beams at things. You know, like,
yeah.
I don't know. I look at the girl in white, and I'm like, you look like somebody that's going to shoot light beams at people. Like, that's just the vibe I'm getting.
And the guy in the center, for a second, when I saw him in a trailer, I was like, wait, is that Bucky? But then I was like, no, that's not Sebastian Stan.
He does have a similar jaw line, doesn't he?
But it's definitely not. It's definitely not. I mean, this is going to... The thing that I really like about the new wave of movies that we're getting is that obviously it's continuing off of what happened after Endgame, because obviously we're getting, you know, when that little trailer thing that we all saw, where it announced the sequels to, we're getting the sequels to, like, the third Spider-Man, we're getting another Thor, you know, the sequels to Black Panther and Captain Marvel. It's a continuation. It's not like a whole new era.
Yeah.
And I just really love that. It's like, this is going till, I think they said 2024.
So I'm going to make a wild prediction now. Based on what something you were just said made like an idea for a really crazy prediction that if this ends up being true, I will laugh hysterically. I will also totally not be disappointed if this is not true, because Marvel is famous for fake outs.
Yeah.
In trailers.
Mm-hmm.
So think about this. The thing that I just commented on and made the joke about, all this stuff happened and you said you've just been observing until now you decided to get involved.
Right.
What if that's actually not as big a deal to the overall plot of the film as I made the joke to be?
Probably.
What if somewhere around the end of the first act, or the beginning of the second act, where we've got caught up through ancient history, we're now in modern times.
Yep.
You know how in Endgame, they took the old footage from films we've already seen and then had the time-traveling versions of the characters? Sorry, spoiler alert for Endgame if anybody's not seen that. Sorry, I should have said that first. Never mind. So think about this, Kevin. What's the biggest plot hole in Endgame that everyone always complains about? They say if this one thing hadn't happened, the rest of the film, nothing would have happened.
With Thanos going back?
Nope.
No?
The one thing that most people I've talked to complain about with Endgame is, so you mean that rat that pushed the button on Scott, to bring him out of the... That's now why we have a movie, because the rat. So think about this.
Yeah.
What if these Eternals have been watching through history and everything and observing, and we're now at the end of the first act, and we've now caught up to Endgame, and it's at the end of those 5 years of the time jump, right?
Yep.
And they're like, look, we've got to do something. And they're like, wait, this small guy in the quantum realm, your superpower is transforming into animals, like Beast Boy over in the DC comics. Transform into a rat and go and bring him out so that we can set the universe right. What if that was just a throwaway joke? Boom, the Eternals are the reasons why Endgame happened.
You never know. I mean, anything is possible. Anything is possible.
All we get now. If that's actually what happens,
you gotta play the lottery. Or at least do a time, or at least maybe, or maybe start a fortune teller business.
No, if that's what happens, forget all that now. If that's what happens, I'm quitting my job and I am becoming a movie script writer because I can come up with the ideas right there.
It's kind of interesting too, because like, there's only really two characters who or actors in this whole lineup that I recognize. Like, obviously, like,
you mean from other things?
Yeah, like the actors that play them.
Yeah,
like not from the Marvel Cinematic Universe. I'm just saying the actors, right, actors right. playing. Like I don't recognize a lot of the. I recognize this guy. I just don't remember who he is.
He looked familiar to me as well. I feel like he reminds me of one of the guys in the M. Night Shyamalan Last Airbender. I feel like he was one of the higher ups. I feel like he was in one of the higher ups in the Fire Nation.
Yeah.
Because he's the guy that in one of the little clips in the trailer you might be able to jump back to where he was dancing.
Right.
And it looked like it might have been in India. Like it had like a very...
Wait, Salma Hayek's in here? Where is she?
Oh, who's that? I don't recognize that name.
She's a actress, a Latin actress, I think. Like, this is, like, we all, like, this is, what's her name? Angelina Jolie.
No.
Angelina Jolie's in this movie.
I think that's Angelina Jolie?
I'm almost positive. If that's not her, I'm almost positive that's who it is.
Man. We need to watch this thing from the beginning again, because I need to now look and see if I can, and maybe pause it whenever she's like more in, you know, like full screen, because I did not recognize her as Angelina Jolie.
No.
Wrong button. All right, guys, y'all ready for this? Are we double parked here? Where's the meter? Alright.
Speechful. Listen.
Not her.
Okay, nope, that's not her. That's not her. But that's the girl to the... Oh.
There, right there.
Okay. That does not look like Angelina Jolie.
She's in the movie. I remember when they talked about it at Comic-Con a couple of years ago.
Well, it doesn't look like her.
I remember.
Keep going.
I remember, like, she.
Was, the light.
I remember she was like the big name that everyone was like, she's in the movie.
And not her, obviously.
No.
Unguided, we have helped them progress. Unseen them.
Not her.
Accomplish one.
Speed one.
Throughout the years, we have never interfered.
Yep.
Until now.
Did the audio cut out for you? There it is. Okay. Maybe the table scene.
Thank you for this.
Oh, you're welcome.
So now that Captain Rogers and Iron Man are both gone, who do you think's gonna lead the Avengers?
I could lead them.
Oh. Wait a minute. The eyes. That now looks like Angelina Jolie.
Yeah.
So she wasn't the white-haired girl. Maybe she was the one in the center. It didn't look like her when she was standing in the center of the group.
Hold on one sec. Oh, my camera's completely frozen on this.
Dang.
I don't know what happened there, but okay. Well, anyway. But yeah, no, I remember at Comic-Con, I didn't go there, but like I'm looking up that when they announced all the characters, and yeah, I think a lot of these characters, a lot of the actors were there, including Jolie.
Okay. Well, that her the girl currently on screen is definitely Angelina Jolie.
Yeah.
But I don't know if she was the one standing center when the whole team was standing on the field. Maybe it was just my screen was too blurry from that distance. But
maybe.
That's really awesome. I had no idea she was in this. Yeah. I've not heard any of the announcements about this or anything.
The only reason I knew was because of that thing at Comic-Con,
mm-hmm.
when they said, oh, by the way, they were like, we have Angelina Jolie.
And there you have it.
Yeah. But yeah, no, this is going to be I'm excited for this movie. I'm really interested to see what it's all about and all that.
Same. I think it's going to be epic.
Mm-hmm.
Even though I know nothing about this going in, I actually kind of like that. I'm going to go in and this is going to feel like a completely new story to me, you know?
Same. But yeah. But anyway, guys, I know you guys can't see me right now. I don't know when my webcam froze. I do apologize about that, but I think it kept going for the whole trailer, so which was nice. But again, Will, thank you so much for coming in. I appreciate you I'm glad we got to do this today. Make sure you guys go and sub to Will. His link will be in the description below.
Hello, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay, I couldn't hear you there for a while. The picture was green, but I couldn't hear you.
Huh. Well, I was saying, make sure everyone can go sub to you. Your link will be in the description below.
Oh, thank you, man. I appreciate that.
And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys hit that like button and subscribe if you guys are new. And keep an eye out because there's going to be a lot more reaction videos coming in the near future for sure. But again, thank you, Will, for hanging out. This is a lot of fun. Any final words? I guess not.
Did you say something? Because
I said any final words.
Oh, I can't hear you, Kevin. That's my final words.
Oh, my God. Why are there so many technical issues at the end? Oh, man. Anyway, thank you, guys.
Bye, guys. Hope you all enjoyed.
Thanks, guys. And we'll see you in the next video.